Yeah, this is the story of Cinderella. Once upon a time in a corn country, there lived a very beautiful burro by the name of Rendicella. Now, Rendicella lived with her muggly other and two sad visitors. Also in the same corn country, there lived a very prancing hen. Just so happened the prancing hen was going to have a bansy fall, so he invited all the people for Riles Mound, especially the pitch people. Well, it came the night of the bansy fall, and Rendicella just kept there in shrine, because all she had to wear were some old ruddy dags. Well, while Rendicella kept their shrine, all at once before her appeared her Gary Fodmother. And she said, Rendicella, you can go to the bansy fall as long as you get home before the mid-12 strikes clock. Well, immediately Rendicella's Gary Fodmother waved her magic wand, and in front of Rendicella appeared Hicks White Sources and a coach. Well, immediately Rendicella climbed into the coach and headed toward the bansy fall. And as soon as she arrived at the bansy fall, the prince young hints, he fell in love with her because he'd been weeping at her through a pindo. Well, they danced and they danced all night long. Then all of a sudden the mid-12 struck clock, and Rendicella remembered what her Gary Fodmother had told her, so she staced down the rare's butt, and she swapped her dripper. Well, the prince of young hens, he went over and picked up that slop dripper, and he vowed to find out who that slop dripper fit and dip. He tried on Rendicella's muggly other, but it fit and dip. He tried on Rendicella's two sad fishers, fit and dip. Then he tried on Rendicella, and it fit and dip, so they got married and lived happily ever after. So the story of the Maury is this. If you want to go to a bansy fall and have a prancing young hens to loll in front with you, don't forget to slop your dripper.